want to talk about webs 1, 2, and 3.0, as well as IoT. Do any of you remember web 1.0? Now, I think of it as flat or static. It was certainly slow and required your computer to dial up through your landline to connect to whichever company or school was offering you network access. Email was the best part of it. Also, millions of websites were created, but you had to know the coding language, HTML, to be a part of that. Every company created their own media player or software, and the only way you could use it was by downloading it or buying it. Then Web 2.0 arrived. It made the internet collaborative and social. Anyone could have their opinions on the internet via comments on articles or by getting their own blogs. Knowing programming language was not required. There was also an emphasis on free or inexpensive programs, many of which did not require downloading. Web 3.0 required a change in the language used to code web pages. Although the average user still didn't need to know about any of those specifics, essentially it was a grammar change. Instead of only having nouns and objects in the programming language, some smart people, Tim Berners-Lee, the creator of the World Wide Web, and some of his friends, decided that verbs and adjectives were necessary. I'm speaking in metaphor, of course. But there needed to be some way to let the web know when you were talking about iced tea, the drink, or iced tea, the rapper and actor, especially since most people will search for iced tea, I-C-E-T-E-A, which is the incorrect spelling for both words. This problem was solved and resolved in the semantic web, but to most of us, it's just known as Web 3.0. An example of Web 3.0 is that I purchased airplane tickets the other day and had the itinerary sent to my Gmail account. Then, on the day I was supposed to fly out, Google sent me updates on my phone telling me whether the flight was on time still and what time I should leave for the airport. Can you see how many connections were made there automatically without me having to do the work? Another example are the knowledge boxes that pop up when you do searches now, or when you just bought coffee on Amazon and now see an ad for similar coffee on Facebook. Or how nowadays when you search for a steakhouse, you don't need to put your city because your computer, tablet, or cell phone usually knows where you are and they return nearby results. As amazing as Web 3.0 is, the Internet of Things, or IoT, begins to take us into the science fiction world of the future. The Internet of Things pertains to connected devices or smart devices. According to Wikipedia, the first one was a Coke machine in 1982 that was able to report inventory and temperature of cans. Nowadays, we have cars that seem to want to drive the car without you, lane assist, parking assist, and on and on. There are apps to find out where you parked your car or where your keys are. And in large stores like Lowe's, the app will tell you the row number of where the item is you want. Your refrigerator is connected not just as a place for information, but it can show you a picture of what's inside while you're at the store. The most notable change to the average user was from Web 1.0 to 2.0, but fortunately everything since has been absorbed by us normal users as the internet without needing to know the background per se. In review, we can think of 1.0 as static because change requires specialty. Web 2.0 is all about collaboration and freedom. Web 3.0 is about personalization and connectedness. And the Internet of Things is about using technology to improve our convenience.